Once upon a time, there was a young girl called Margaret who lived with her father in the country. Her mother had died when she was a little girl, and her father, a rich merchant, often had to be away from home. While off on one of his trips, he married again. And as our story begins, Margaret is eagerly awaiting the arrival of her new mother.
Tell me what you think, dear old oak tree. Shall I bake a great big raisin cake as a surprise for my new mother? Or shall I pick a lovely bouquet of fresh flowers? Flowers, you say? And what do you think, my funny old friend? You're for the raisin cake, of course. What about you, Humphrey? You think both, I know, because you're such a good boy. Linda! Linda, I want eggs, flour, sugar, and milk. I'm going to bake a lovely cake for my new mother. Oh, and don't forget the raisins. And Linda, would you fill Father's pipe and put it near his favorite chair?
Margaret's new stepmother had brought her two daughters with her. They were beautifully dressed and thought themselves very fine ladies, but actually they were wicked and spiteful.
Father!
This is my dear daughter, Margaret. And here are your new mother and your two new sisters, Lottie and Dottie. There. Give the horses some water. I must leave at once for the fair.
Well, so you're my new grown-up daughter. Thank you, my child. Kiss Mama's hand.
Yes, indeed.
I hope you'll get along well together.
Oh, yes, Papa.
What would you like me to bring back for you?
Oh, pretty dresses and shoes.
Bracelets and necklaces and precious jewelry.
And you, Margaret?
Oh, Father. A twig of the first tree that you see. Break it off for me, will you?
Margaret, you're as modest as ever, but I'll find something nice for you, too.
Miss Margaret, the cake.
Give it to me.
Goodbye.
Here, Father, oh. I bake this raisin cake for your journey.
Thank you, my child. Thank you. Bye, children. Bye.
Is that dumb little goose going to eat with us?
Certainly not.
She belongs in the kitchen.
You played a great joke on her with that raisin cake.
I would like to welcome you here.
Mama suffers terribly from headaches. She must be well looked after.
Yes, so Lottie must be in full charge of running the house.
You will understand, of course.
Yes. Who are all these people?
These are all our dear old servants. Linda, Dan, Lisa and John the gardener.
At home, we only had one maid for the whole house, didn't we?
Naturally. Here, we can share the work between the three of us.
We'll be in charge of the house. And you can do all the kitchen work and clean out the stables.
Of course, you won't be able to wear such a lovely dress for that kind of work.
Come on, we can talk about all that in the house. Leave those. Put your new clothes on the kitchen table.
You can go and change in there.
That dress is far too nice for the kitchen.
Go and take it off. We'll look after it for you.
Mm-hmm.
Oh. We'll have to get everything here looking as bright as a new pin. Where's Margaret?
In the kitchen.
Just where the proud little princess belongs.
Comfortable.
Any objection?
Lazy boss.
And so the arrival of Margaret's new mother brought her nothing but unhappiness. All her pretty dresses were taken away from her, and she had to work like a slave from morning till night. She got up before dawn to start cleaning the house and cooking. And at night, she was not allowed a bed of her own, but had to sleep in the hearth among the cinders.
Margaret, when will lunch be ready?
As quickly as I can manage.
You haven't even peeled the potatoes yet. You haven't even lit the oven yet.
I was just going to get the wood.
Oh! Oh! Margaret, the pitcher by the stove is empty. Margaret, go get some water.
First, you must give my shoes a good polish.
Margaret, come here. Your place is in the kitchen. Lunch must be ready in 10 minutes. Do you hear?
But, sister...
Mustn't eat with us anymore.
No, she's always full of cinders.
Like a Cinderella.
Cinderella, that's good. Cinderella.
Margaret's father had bought his stepdaughters the presents they had asked for. As he was riding through a forest, he passed a hazel tree and remembered his other daughter. He stopped and broke a twig off to take back home to Margaret. Poor little Cinderella didn't even have time for her beloved animals. In the past, she had loved to spend many happy hours petting them and talking to them. But now she barely had time to give them their food.
Here's your hay. Yes. Yes. I'm coming right away. I haven't forgotten you. It's all right. I'm coming as soon as I can.
Cinderella! Cinderella!
Yes?
Cinderella!
Yes, I'm coming.
Poor little Cinderella. She worked so hard for those stupid, stuck-up, lazy, ugly sisters of hers. It was a wonder she didn't become ill.
Cinderella, what are you doing sitting around like that, lazy bones? Cinderella!
Yes, I'm coming.
Coo-coo-ree-coo, what shall we do, what shall we do? Cinderella, who was so gay, is crying her heart out night and day. Coo-coo-ree-coo, what shall we do, what shall we do? Every animal, large and small, meet at the oak tree, one and all.
And so all the animals came to the old oak tree to see what they could do to help poor Cinderella. They decided to wake up Curly Quacks, a funny little man who lived in the roots, and Miss Holly, the good fairy of the tree. Something had to be done.
Coo-coo-ree-coo, what shall we do, what shall we do? Dear Miss Holly, wake from your sleep. Cinderella must never weep. Coo-coo-ree-coo, coo-coo-ree-coo, Curly Quacks, we want you too.
What's going on round here? Ah, yes. Cinderella's in a lot of trouble. Miss Holly, Miss Holly! Wake up! Wake up! Hey, Miss Holly, wake up! We've got a lot of work to do! Wake up, will you? Poor little Cinderella's in trouble.
Do you mean Margaret? How is she?
The dear old woman snored her way through everything again. The ugly sisters are making Cinderella's life miserable. They never give her a moment's peace. She has to work morning, noon, and night.
Curly Quacks told the good fairy, who had been living in the tree for over 1,000 years, everything that had happened since Cinderella's mother had died.
Yes, but what are we going to do? What she needs is someone to help her. A prince is what she should have at her side.
I know the one. Young Prince Charming in the White Castle. The one who's always so sad because he feels so lonely.
Yes, yes, he's looking for a princess, but he can't find the one he wants. This one's too fat, that one's too thin. This one's too tall, that one's too short. One's too stupid, another's too sly. No wonder he can't find one he wants to marry.
First, we must somehow or other manage to make the prince laugh. But when he laughs, he must be happy. And when someone is happy, then he can make someone else happy too. Right? Right.
How would it be if we arranged he should dream of her?
Oh! I have it. I'll go to the princess's jester and tell him all about Cinderella.
Oh, my. No, no, no. That won't do at all. I'll have to go, too. Curly Quacks is too impetuous. You look after my house for me. Curly Quacks, you go on ahead. I'll be along just as soon as I've had a word with Cinderella.
Soon the father came back from his journey. He was so happy to see his wife and children again. He hoped that his presence would bring all of them their heart's desire. He was surprised, though, that Margaret was wearing such a shabby old dress. He gave her the twig from the hazel tree and promised that next time he would bring her something really beautiful. But before he had time to talk to her, his wife ran up and dragged him away, and Cinderella was once again left all alone.
Out of the way, fatty.
I'm not fat at all. I want to see myself.
You're so fat, you'll burst soon.
How dare you say such a thing?
Shh, Papa.
You see, my dear, how beautifully the dresses you bought suit them.
Uh-huh. But why has Margaret got such a dirty old dress on?
Well, she spends all her time sitting in the cinders.
She's given all her nice dresses away.
We gave her some lovely ones of ours, but she's just a Cinderella.
A real little Cinderella.
How is this possible? I've always seen her beautifully dressed.
Are you suggesting it's our fault, then?
Papa!
You've seen what she really wants. A twig from a tree.
Cinderella went to her mother's grave to plant the twig there. Suddenly she felt so unhappy that the tears began to pour down her cheeks. The good fairy was watching her and wanted to comfort her. She changed herself into an old peasant woman so as not to scare her. She laid her hand on Cinderella's head and cast one of her magic spells. And suddenly, oh, look.
You were shedding just now for your mother have a magic power. Whenever there's something you really want, come and stand under the tree and repeat these magic words. Shiver, shiver, little tree, throw your present down to me. Then the tree will grant whatever you wish. You must trust me, Cinderella. I look after you. I'm your fairy godmother.
Thank you.
horses are ready. Thank you.
So trampled on by my horse? Are you crazy, you fool? Come on.
Yes, yes, I'm a crazy fool. That's exactly what I am. I'm offering you my services as court jester. You always look so sad. I want to cheer you up and make you laugh again. Ha! Huh?
You'll never succeed.
I have a bet with you, Prince. After one day at the castle, if twice I've managed to make you laugh at my jokes, you'll appoint me your official court jester, huh? What do you say to that?
All right. Make yourself known to my chamberlain, Bimblestein. Come on.
Prince Charming was very sensitive to noise. Careful there. Look out. Oh, dear, 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 dear. If they're not careful, they'll get into trouble with the man who is responsible for seeing that nothing should disturb the prince. The court chamberlain, Baron Bimble of Bimblestein. As you can see, he takes his duties very seriously.
Hey there. Can you tell me where I can find the Lord Chamberlain, Bimble of Bimblestein?
Well, now, who are you and what do you want?
I'm the new court jester, the one who's going to make the prince laugh again.
Ah, we have a new jester, do we? Not a bad idea, but I hope you are very funny. I can only allow the prince to be disturbed if you are really very, very funny.
I'm just as funny as my name. Do you know what I'm called? Bumble of Bumblestein.
Bumble? A Bumblestein? Impossible! You didn't know that my name is Bimble or Bimblestein. Wait a minute. You can't possibly be a cousin of mine. Otherwise, we'd be related, wouldn't we? Let me see. Bimblestein with a U. I wonder if I ever had any ancestors who went by that name.
I'm Bimble from Bumblestein and I have many cousins. I wonder if you're one of mine. I've got them by the dozens.
Bimble, Bamble, Bumble, it's a crazy mix of jumble. My Bimble's not so bumble, even closer if you mumble.
We're Bimble and we're Bumble and our meeting here was fated. Since Bimble sounds like Bumble, then we surely are related.
Bimble, Bumble, Bumble, it's a crazy mix of jumble. Cause Bimble's closer, Bumble, even closer if you mumble.
Bimble and we're Bumble, and you look like my brother, except that he's my sister, who's the daughter of my mother.
Bimble, Bumble, Bumble, it's a crazy mix of jumble. Cause Bimble's also Bumble, even closer if you mumble.
Well now, I really must see the prince.
I shall go with you to tell the prince about all this. Perhaps it will make him laugh for the first time. My dear Bumble and Bumblestein, come with me.
Your Royal Highness, this princess has a dowry of no less than 100,000 gold crowns.
Your Highness, Your Highness, oh, oh, Your Highness, there's a man outside who says his name is Bumble of Bumblestein. The idiot has some crazy idea about wanting to be appointed court jester to your highness.
Ah, yes, he made a bet with me this morning. Let him in.
Oh, excuse me, your highness. The princess has fallen out of her frame, but she's not for you.
Which of them is for me, then? Look them all over.
She's no good for you, your highness. She's a regular beanpole.
The princess of Reasonland.
Ah, this one's so fat, she looks ready to burst. No, your highness, I know the only girl in the world who's fit to be your bride.
Who is this girl you have such a high opinion of?
She's perfect. I describe her as lovelier than the sun and the moon put together. By the way, your highness, have I won my bet yet?
Yes.
Do something for me. Just for a second, keep your eyes shut, and I'll show you a vision of a young girl well worthy of being your highness's wife.
What are you doing there? Now she's vanished.
How would it be if we searched for her?
That's what we'll do.
I saw her not very long ago here in the town.
I swear the girl in the dream will one day become my princess.
Your Highness, may I humbly remind you that the Princess of Raisinland has announced that she is personally coming to visit you, and she's incredibly rich.
Your Highness, why don't you announce that you are giving a party to which all the young girls in the land are invited?
But, Your Highness, that's not...
Whether she be a tinker or a peddler woman, a fishmonger or a washerwoman, all the girls in the land must be invited.
But I'm telling you, that's not possible.
I really don't mind if it's possible or not. I know at last what it feels like to be happy.
But I tell you, it's not possible.
Gentlemen, give me your attention. His Royal Highness wishes to announce
that from all the lovely maidens in the land, someone will be chosen as his princess. You are all invited to attend a very special, elegant affair. That's when the prince will make his royal mind up.
He will decide on a princess from all the maidens gathered there.
The most beautiful, with a heart that's pure, and a form that is lovely to behold, and one with the grace to sit by the side of the prince who would take her.
Invited to the prince's ball.
What are we going to wear?
Yes, what'll we wear?
I wish it could be me. I wish it would be me. Now every girl dreams that a handsome prince will come along and make her his bride to be. I wish that it could be me. Oh, how brightly I'd shine. Yes, the world would be mine if the prince would take my. I wish it would be me. I'm sure he'll notice all my charms.
Land are invited, can I go along as well?
You stupid girl. Do you think we take you to the ball?
In that shabby old dress of yours?
What
How
an
dumb
idea.
Can you get?
I know, but I thought maybe you'd let me wear one of your old dresses.
Put on one of our dresses? Are you mad? You must have gone right out of your mind.
Why don't you come as you are? You'd be the belle of the ball.
How can I fix that pair of monsters, huh? As a clown, I could tease them.
And as a cook?
As a cook, I'd put too much salt in their soup.
As a police sergeant? You could arrest them.
Oh.
No, I know what. Since that pair of misses are so conceited, you can go as their hairdresser. You can go and tease their hair around a little. They both need it.
You have dresses which are just as pretty as theirs.
Oh, Mother, the prince has invited all girls. Let me go to the ball, too, please.
You? You?
Would you believe it? This grubby little Cinderella wants to go to the court ball.
Just imagine what the prince would say if she showed up.
Cinderella, Cinderella, you are such a mess. In your shabby dress, who would even guess that you'd want an invitation to the royal ball? You could win a prize.
Mother, let me go to the ball with you. I beg you, let me go just this once.
All right, Margaret. Yes. If you can pick all these lentils out of the hearth and put them back within an hour, then you may come to the ball. There!
Pick up all those hundreds of lentils in 1 hour. Oh, I'll never be able to do that.
Cinderella. Haven't you always fed the birds all through the winter? They would like to thank you. Why don't you go out and call them?
What? All the birds in the sky?
Yes, all the birds in the sky.
Turtle doves, all you little birds in the blue sky, come and help me with the lentils.
Oh,
turtle doves who've flown down from your nests. Have you all come here to try and help your friend? Do you see all those lentils lying in the hearth? We've got to pick them all up in an hour. The good ones go into the bowl. The others, down your tummies. Oh, how busy your beaks are now. Look at you all, picking like mad. Scratching away with your feet as well. Working for me like the good friends you are. Oh, the bowl is full and the hearth is clean. Where can all those hundreds of lentils have gone to? It's as if a miracle had happened. There's not a single lentil left in the hearth. Thank you, little birds. You've been good friends. Now my stepmother must take me to the ball. You can fly away now. Your work is all done.
I can cut your hair, wash your hair, set your hair, tint your hair, manicure your hands and feet and make you soft and smooth and sweet. And trick you, too.
Curly quacks, my lad. Mind you, don't go and make those two look too good now.
Don't you worry yourself about that.
Oh, what wonderful air you have. One must treat it with the greatest care. Oh, just one little piece of the top there.
My hair!
Would you like it back again?
Get out of here, you wretch!
Ooh, la la. Okay, I'm on my way.
Mama, now I won't be able to go to the ball.
Don't cry, my child. This hat will hide it. Nobody will notice.
Bowl is full.
Oh, but that was just a little joke of mine. You simply cannot go to the ball like that, and you have nothing else to put on.
Cinderella, don't you remember? Your magic tree is ready to help you.
Here, here. Oh, I'm so sorry. Did I hurt you, sir?
Come here, my friend. Come here. Please, come with me. My dear Bumblestein, the prince has invited every girl in the land here. Yes, all of them without exception.
All of them?
Yes.
Oh, that is really not...
Not possible. What if they all want to dance with him?
And not only that, he's going to choose one of them to be his wife, don't forget.
But that's impossible.
Yes. And he will only marry the one he saw in his dream the other day, even if she turns out to be just a simple little Cinderella.
But that's impossible!
Everything is possible, gentlemen. Tell the girls to come forward, and please treat them all as if they were the noblest ladies in the land.
That is it?
Possible.
Shiver, shiver, little tree. Throw your present down to me.
Oh. A lovely dress and fit for a princess. It suits you, my dear, wonderfully. You see? A princess should wear a crown on her head, shouldn't she? What have we here? A golden nut. Would you believe it? Just look what it's become.
Now
we need two white horses, don't we? Rusty and Dusty, come and help our little Cinderella. Why, look. Humphrey, would you like to be the coachman? Yes? Come on, then. And you, Richard the Rooster, can be the footman. Good morning, Richard. You must be home punctually on the stroke of 12. Otherwise, the spell will be broken. And you'll turn back into Cinderella before the prince's very eyes. With no coach and no servants.
I will.
But a real princess would have maids of honor, wouldn't she?
Oh.
Come on, little geese, flap your wings and turn into maids of honor. Out with your wings. That's it. That's right. I should go to the ball, too. Princesses get lightheaded. But how? I've nothing to wear.
I can get you a new dress, fairy godmother, in no time at all. Why don't you go as the queen of the fairies?
Oh, come on now. As queen of the fairies? I'm over 1,000 years old.
Well, then, go into the prince's picture gallery and choose a dress from one of the portraits of his ancestors.
That's a good idea. I'll surprise everyone. Just you wait and see.
All the girls in the land?
Yes, but the prettiest, I think, are Lottie and Dottie. And incidentally, their father is a very wealthy merchant.
I don't want a girl with money. I'm looking for... Let the dancing begin.
Bittersweet. We might as well join them. You don't mean the Princess of Raisinland?
No, this is...
Oh, heavens. What am I to do? The entire castle is filled with girls from... Oh, your highness.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Princess...
What's happened? Why has the music stopped? Play. Play as beautifully as you can. I want to dance. Tell me if you don't wish to. But if you want to make me really happy, you will dance with me the whole night long.
Bit of a scare. Oh, I know. Now.
still dancing. It will soon be 12. We must get Cinderella away from here immediately. Cinderella. Cinderella, come here. Come here. Cinderella, come here. Oh. Look, Cinderella's dancing over there, but she must go home now. Go and get her away from the prince, because the clock is striking 12. Shoo!
Where are you going?
Princess! Princess!
Princess!
The lady I was dancing with, have you seen her?
Yes, she ran away, and she was so beautiful.
Help me! Look for her! I must find her! Isn't that her dress sparkling over there?
I think
no,
so.
No, Prince, look there, over there!
We've got to find her. She can't be far away.
The Princess of Raisinland has disappeared!
Far.
Well, what are you all standing about there for? This way! Follow me!
What are you doing here? It's against all etiquette.
I'm looking for the princess. She ran into the birdhouse.
Oh, but that's impossible, Your Highness. Princesses don't run into birdhouses. It's simply not done.
But this one did, Lord Chamberlain.
It's not possible.
Your Highness, what an honor. May we offer you some tea?
No, thank you. It's much too late. I wonder if I might ask you if you would open the door of the birdhouse.
The birdhouse, Did you say? Is it locked then?
Yes.
Hey, Cinderella!
Cinderella,
you lazy bird!
Hurry,
open up the birdhouse immediately! Hurry!
Where'd she go?
Your Highness, why don't you tell the mole that you're going to give another ball tomorrow? Then you'll be sure to find her again.
A good idea. Huh. All of you, listen. I shall hold another ball tomorrow.
The prince will try to find out what each and every one of you can do, what all of you girls learnt at school. For you know, to be a real queen is not all that easy. Follow me.
Whoop. Everything's going very well, my children. Come on, we'll talk about it inside. Did you see that? He's mine, I know it.
I'm afraid you're wrong. He'll marry me. We spent most of the evening talking to a princess.
She wouldn't even deign to talk to anyone else.
The prince took the trouble to bring us home.
He smiled at everything I said.
Come on, she doesn't understand.
How could she? She had to stay at home.
Cinderella, come and help me take my dress off.
The next day, everyone in the house was in a flurry of excitement. But of course, nobody took any notice of poor Cinderella. As she swept the terrace, she thought of Prince Charming and the White Castle. Meanwhile, her stepmother was racking her brains, trying to think how she could manage to make one of her daughters queen. But she never gave a thought to Cinderella.
Mama!
Coming! Mama! This hat won't stay put.
Mama! Help me fasten my dress!
Shall I try again? Do I dare make another wish at the tree?
Yes, yes!
Do it! Do it!
Do it! Do it! Do it! Do it!
Shiver, shiver, little tree. Throw your present down to me.
Lord Chamberlain, Is she still not here?
I'm afraid not, Your Highness.
I am the Princess of Raisinland, you know. I hope my arrival was announced. There's a prince around, I hear. Well, who is the lucky one? Where is he? Are you the prince?
Sorry, no.
Well, is it you then?
I'm even sorrier.
Then it must be you.
I'm sorriest of all.
I'm afraid there's no prince around here, but why don't you marry me? We'd make a perfect royal couple.
Coming back?
No, wait a minute. Is she at her?
I thought you'd never come.
What is your name? Where do you come from? Do tell me something about yourself. All the girls here have told me where they live and what they do. Won't you do the same?
That won't be easy. She's so sweet and refined. I guarantee she's never done a day's work in her life.
A little baby doll. Like me.
Children, stop it. Will you behave?
My name, Your Highness, stays a secret. And as for my work, it is very humble. I have my dreams, but I don't reveal them to anyone. I polish and I cook. I wash and scrub floors. I sew and mend until I'm exhausted.
Come with me and we'll lead the dance. From now on, I shall dance with no one but you.
Come on, we've heard enough.
Excuse me. Do what I told you this morning. This time she won't get away. That is my partner, gentlemen. You, Bittersweet, and you, Bimblestein, may dance with those ladies there.
The prince has something up his sleeve, you know. We must watch very carefully to make sure that Cinderella can get away again.
It isn't all that late yet. This time, though, we'll help her better.
Must have something up his sleeve.
Yes, yes, I've noticed that too, but what?
That's what the two of us have got to find out.
Why did you run away yesterday? Why won't you tell me who you are?
Prince Charming, if you only knew who I was.
Even if you were the poorest girl in my whole land, I would want you to be my queen.
I can't. I really can't. Please let me go.
Please, will everyone listen? I wish to tell you all whom I have chosen as your queen.
I.
Princess! 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 Chamberlain, now I have this slipper in my hand, and I will search for her throughout the whole land.
Your Highness, this is impossible.
We're Siamese twins.
No, keep back, keep back. Oh, too late.
Thank you.
doves, I've lost a shoe. I really don't know what to do. The other one I've hidden so my stepmother will never know.
Grrr, cookery-coo, it's a lucky shoe.
Margaret! Margaret!
Is that the prince?
Margaret!
Father, you're back!
How are you, my child? This time you can choose which present you want. Come on.
Oh, look, Mama. The prince is coming here. I'm going to be queen. Cinderella, come help me make myself beautiful.
Mama, how can I become a princess in a house coat? Cinderella, you stupid little thing, what do you think you're doing?
Shh, your father's home.
Oh, Mama.
Come on. Dottie.
The only girl in the whole land whom I will marry is the one whose foot fits this shoe.
Is that the shoe which you found yesterday on the castle
yes.
steps? I lost it. Give it to me. Not here. You mustn't change here. It's not proper.
Your Majesty. Majesty.
Uh-oh.
The shoe is too small. It doesn't fit. It hurts. I can't even get my big toe in.
Cut it off, then, and hide the pain. As queen, you'll never have to walk again.
The shoe fits. Here is your bride. It fits. It fits.
Cuckoo-ricoo, there's blood on the shoe. For her big foot, it's far too small. She's not the bride for you at all.
Blood on the shoe? The shoe's too small.
No.
She cannot be the one I'm looking for.
No.
Madam, you have another daughter.
Forgive the child for deceiving you. It was only love that made her do it.
Very well.
This is my other pretty little daughter. I'm sure she's the right one.
Oh, no. Oh, no, the shoe's too small. I can't even begin to get the heel in.
Cut it off, then. After your marriage, you'll always ride in a golden carriage.
The shoe fits. Look, Mother, look. I'll be the bride. The prince's bride.
What have you to say, little doves?
Cuckoo-ricoo, there's blood on the shoe. For her big foot, it's far too small. She's not the bride for you at all.
Your Highness, welcome to my house.
Thank you. No, thank you. Are these all the daughters you have?
Oh, no. I have another little daughter.
You don't mean you're going to show him Cinderella?
That little ninny? In a shabby little dress?
I would like to see her, please.
Oh.
I'm afraid you'll find her very shy.
Call her.
Margaret, come here.
Cinderella, Cinderella, you are such a mess. In your shabby dress, she is no princess.
Please try on the shoe. I have a feeling that this time it will really fit. The shoe fits you. It's yours, then.
And this must be the other one.
It can't be the other
one. No, 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 no!
Well, little doves, what do you have to say now?
Cuckoo-ricoo, cuckoo-ricoo. Now we see no blood on the shoe. Cinderella's the bride for you.
sister.
Would you like to have a lady-in-waiting?
Two ladies-in-waiting.
Your Highness, that's going too far. They nearly drove Cinderella out of her mind.
Really?
If you take those two snakes into the castle with you, they'll never give you a moment's peace.
Quiet.
Don't believe a single word they say. They're a pair of troublemakers and cats. They can't talk without telling lies.
Yeah!
Yeah!
Don't listen to them, Cinderella. They can't be your lady.
Who are you?
Why don't we let the new princess decide? Let Cinderella say what their punishment shall be.
Yes, Cinderella. You tell us what you think. And all of you listen to her words.
I don't think they should be punished too severely. Let them do the same work as I did for 1 year.
I give you my word, they'll mend their ways. I've been away from home too often. It's time they were taught how to behave.
Papa!
You can't be so cruel to us.
See that they are shown what to do. You must show that you're sorry by working hard.
Your Highness, we're both too elegant to work.
Oh, that can soon be changed, can't it? Off you go now.
Fairy godmother, won't you come with us?
No, Cinderella. Goodbye.